So one of the scariest experiences that we can have as a driver is when you go to use your brakes and they don't work at all, or they work really ineffectively and it just feels like the car isn't slowing up. So what causes this condition of brake fade? Well, it's usually down to driver habit. So we're going to look at brake fade, what it is, what causes it, but we're also going to look at the potential for mechanical problems to cause brake fade, and also some upgrades that we can do to our car to minimize the risk of suffering from brake fade in the future. And that might be something you want to do if you're doing a lot of spirited driving or a lot of track work where the brakes are getting hotter. So what is brake fade? Well, effectively, brake fade is where the brakes have faded. They're not working effectively, and it's nearly always down to excessive heat buildup. So thinking about the way the brakes work, you've got a pad, a brake pad pressing against a brake disc or brake rotor. So depending on where you live, there'll be a different name for it, but that causes friction and friction causes heat. The problem comes about when this heat buildup becomes excessive and the pad actually starts giving off gases. It starts smoking or smouldering. And that little layer of gases between the pad and the rotor or the disc surface will prevent the friction from happening and act as a barrier or a lubricant between those two surfaces. And that's what causes brake fade. Well, that's the biggest cause of brake fade. The other avenue that can happen is the brake fluid itself also gets hot. And brake fluid is very absorbent of water. It's hygroscopic, where water is attracted to it, which is a good reason to change your brake fluid at the correct intervals, because it does degrade over time. And water inside will definitely boil at a much lower temperature than the brake fluid. And when this brake fluid gets hot and the gases start to build up inside that, they become compressible and spongy, and that can add to this spongy feel at the brake pedal. So brake components, the pads, the rotors, the discs, and even the fluid work best at specified temperatures. Now, for most everyday driving, you're just using your brakes periodically to slow the car up every now and then. In spirited driving, you're using the brakes a lot harder. They're doing a lot more work and they will get hotter. But also, the rookie mistake that a lot of drivers make is when they're going downhill to arrest the speed or the acceleration rather than drop to a lower gear and allow engine braking to arrest the acceleration of the car. They use the brakes and they ride the brakes, so the brakes are on very gently for the entire duration of a hill. And that puts so much heat in the system that when they come to use the brakes again at the bottom of the hill or just after the hill, they don't work. There's too much heat in the system and they've become ineffective. So for the spirited driver or the track day driver, what can we do? Well, we can specify pads that are more tolerant of higher temperatures. So we would call these race spec pads. Most brake pad manufacturers have a heat range that they recommend. And if you're doing a lot of the hot spirited driving, these hotter temperature ranges produce less gas and provide greater friction, but they often need to be at a set temperature before they start biting properly. And they can be quite noisy when they're cold. So sometimes these extreme track pads are not suitable for road use. I've done other detailed videos on pads and brake selection as well. But also the rotors or the discs themselves, if they've got drilled holes in them and grooves, that can help to dissipate the gases that build up between the pad and that metal surface. So it just gives the gases a way to escape. So just fitting uprated discs that have those features can go a long way to preventing the problems associated with brake fade, even when the discs or the rotors and the pads get really hot. So other mechanical problems is the brake servo might start to fail. And I've done another video looking at the brake servo and how this works. It basically amplifies your braking pressure. And if that's leaking or there's an air leak in the system, it won't do that as effectively. And you'll tend to find there's very little movement in the brake pedal and it's very hard to press the brakes on. But generally the brakes will still work. You'll just have less control and less feel over it. And another time that your brakes will just fade and stop working is if you've driven through deep water. If the brakes themselves have become wet, they're not going to stop the car as effectively. And that's really why they recommend after you drive through water, you just apply the brake very gently just to get rid of the water that has built up on the surface of the rotor or disc and the pad to restore the car's braking ability. So I hope this video has been useful to you. Please boot that like button. That really does help us to get out there. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do so. We'd love you to stay tuned and have a look at this video that I've lined up for you that you should find really interesting. Thanks for watching. See you in this next video.